New home sales numbers will be released tomorrow, and there might be reason to be optimistic after Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke told lawmakers yesterday the housing market should begin to improve in the coming months.
I would anticipate some stabilization in the housing market going forward, and eventually demographic trends, household formation, economic growth will begin to create a recovery in the housing market.
Despite the hopeful words from Bernanke, the S&P Case-Shiller Home Index of Prices released yesterday showed record declines in home prices for the month of December. For more on the future of housing, we have Pete Zipkin. He joins us from San Francisco. He has been unable to find a fixed-rate mortgage, and Alan Morris is owner of the real estate firm Alan Morris Company. I want to start with you, Pete. You're a 35-year-old technology executive. You have good credit, and you say you have 20% equity in your home. What are banks telling you as you search for a jumbo loan?
Well, the banks have all started the process by saying that they're capable of providing loans, but when you go through the process, it ends up in a position in which they deny the loan at the very end of the funding process, always citing declining market conditions.
You know, Pete, it's interesting
very,
because
very
we keep seeing all kinds of efforts to help people on the lower end, folks with mortgages of $417,000 or less. How does that make you feel? You're a productive member of society, and yet it doesn't seem like the government's out to help people in your bracket.
Well, I think the biggest problem is that we need to move towards an environment in which those who pay their bills, who have good credit rating, should be the ones who are provided the loans, despite the amount of the size of the mortgage. It's all about the risk for the banks. And if somebody has proven over time that they pay their taxes, pay their bills, and carry a good credit rating, have a good income, they should be given the loan.
You know, it would seem logical that the folks in that bracket would pay back their loans, but jumbo loans were 14% in the market in 2007. They're only 4% now, according to Insight Mortgage Finance. How hopeful are you that you'll eventually find a jumbo loan in this environment?
Well, I think we need change in the environment. I think we're starting to see that happen with accountability of the banks, all that we're hearing that the government is doing to try and move us in that direction. I think it's going to take time, and it's going to take participation from both sides of the aisle in driving to a solution.
I want to turn to you, Alan. We're getting some mixed messages here from the markets. The Case-Shiller Index is always extremely negative. What are you seeing right now with respect to housing? We've got a lot of housing data still to come this week.
Well, I think that we're going to see these home prices stabilize this year. And it may be a rocky bottom for a while, and then we're going to see the home prices start to go back up again. But this is a normal part of the cycle. We go through this regularly. And I believe in the future of America and in real estate. It's a good investment long term.
Speaking of the normal part of the cycle, the Census Bureau says that homes are actually getting smaller. Is this a natural part of the cycle and something that we should expect to be a permanent part?
Well, I think it is. I think that a lot of people are discovering that just buying a bigger home because they think that's going to make them make a bigger profit when they resell their home. I think people are rethinking that and thinking that really it's a time to buy what you need or build what you need and not a whole lot of excess. This is not a time for excess.
Unfortunately, Americans are getting bigger. How do you feel about housing under the Obama administration so far?
Well, I'm encouraged. I think what he did last night at the address is throw out a life preserver to people that really need help. And this could help 4 to 5 million families, and especially when you think of 13.8 million homes that the values may be below the current mortgage levels, that they're below water in that respect. And this is part of the cycle. We'll see it go down and we'll see it go back up because we have to remember real estate is a long-term investment. And this is going to be good for long-term real estate investments in the future.
Alan, banks are going to start having stress tests real soon. One of the things they're checking for, in addition to what we've seen in the retail, residential part, credit card, but commercial real estate, a lot of rumblings about that being the next shoe to drop. What are you saying?
Well, I think that the economy is going to affects everyone. Everyone's affected by this economy and by this cycle. But it also creates opportunities. As we see some of the commercial banks and other institutions that are retrenching. We're also seeing others that benefit from this cycle in the economy. People that are concerned about this bank will be moving their deposits to stronger regional banks.
But we've got about 10 seconds. Commercial real estate, though, in trouble. Are they going to be able to find refinancing this year?
Well, it depends on the strength of the borrower. But I think that there's good reason why commercial real estate is refinanceable. It depends on your income stream. Right. I believe in the future, and I think that this is a good time to have faith in America, have faith in the future, and have faith in God.
Thanks a lot. I'll be looking to vote for you, Alan. Appreciate it. Pete, good luck with your search out there. Coming up, we're going to talk.